Love and romance have never looked as intoxicating as they do in a Wong Kar Wai film. As one of the most distinctive voices working in cinema today, the director tells highly atmospheric stories of restrained passion, using dazzling visuals, memorable songs, and unconventional narratives. In his neon-drenched world, lonely souls drift around, desperately trying to make a meaningful connection, no matter how fleeting. Wong emerged as part of Hong Kong's second new wave during the mid-80s. He joined the likes of Stanley Kwan, Mabel Jeung, and Clara Law, directors fed up with the tired formulaic conventions of mainstream cinema and eager to experiment with more innovative ways of storytelling. He did that by combining the frenetic energy of MTV with the playful feel of the French New Wave, while pushing the boundaries of Hong Kong genre cinema to create something fresh and inventive. For his debut feature, Wong tackled the gangster crime drama in 1988's As Tears Go By, but it was his third film, Chungking Express, that became his international crossover hit. Quentin Tarantino was such a big fan of the low-budget romance that he distributed it in the US through his Rolling Thunder imprint. Since then, Wong has been name-checked by Lost in Translation director Sofia Coppola during her acceptance speech for the Best Original Screenplay Oscar, while Barry Jenkins has spoken at length about his influence on Moonlight. He is the only Hong Kong filmmaker to ever win the Best Director Prize at Cannes Film Festival. His films are beautiful reveries that explore the poetry and agony of love with brooding melancholy. Wong's impact has been far-reaching, and he remains one of the most exciting auteurs of our generation.
Diana? Are you going to run?
Wong is famous for his signature style that he perfected with the help of Australian cinematographer and frequent collaborator Christopher Doyle. He creates shimmering visual landscapes saturated in striking colours and hazy neon lights. There's a languid sensuality to his hypnotic style, which is interrupted by jump cuts and freeze frames. He often manipulates film speed using the techniques of undercranking, which involves certain scenes being shot at a slow rate so that the action looks faster when it's played back, and step printing, which duplicates individual frames. By combining these methods, he disrupts the audience's sense of how quickly time is passing. Characters appear to be lost in their own thoughts, suspended in slow motion, as everything around them whirls by in a colourful rush of bodies. In the opening scene of Chungking Express, cop 223 is seen chasing a suspect along a busy street. Actor Takeshi Kaneshiro remains sharply in focus, while the mayhem of the city around him is a streaky blur. This technique adds to a sense of dreaminess, people trapped in their solitude, even as they're surrounded by others.
What do you think? I think you shouldn't write anything.
Why? You
write so good, I don't know why.
Wong started out as a TV and film screenwriter. Despite his background, the director is notorious for his aversion to using scripts. He takes a musician's approach to filmmaking, preferring to improvise with his actors to create the characters and develop the plot. Wong likes to write as he shoots and will often change his mind about things at the last minute. Fallen Angels was originally developed as the third story in Chungking Express, while In the Mood for Love began as a film about food. The director prefers not to rehearse so he can capture as much spontaneity as possible from his cast. Even when his films are finished, Wong still considers them a work in progress. He released a redux version of Ashes of Time 14 years after its release, when the original prints were lost. Because of his haphazard way of working, his films can often go over budget and take years to shoot. Tony Leung, his go-to leading man, said in interviews that the director often has enough footage for several different films. Usually, he's just as curious as anyone else to see what the end result will be. A Wong production features the same collaborators he's worked with over the years. He relies on people who know him well and are comfortable with the way he makes films. The director has worked with some of Hong Kong cinema's biggest stars, including Bridget Lin, Tony Leung, Maggie Cheung, and Leslie Cheung, pushing them to deliver some of the best performances of their careers. Doyle, who has worked as a cinematographer on seven of Wong's films, has been a huge creative influence. He brings a renegade energy, an eye for textures, and a knack for tapping into the emotions of the scene, helping the director to develop his unique visual tapestry. Key elements include his dreaming use of lighting, vivid colours, and the kinetic way he moves the camera around. Another important collaborator is William Chang, who takes on many different roles, working as a production designer, art director, costume designer, and editor. Well known for his obsessive attention to detail, he's responsible for the look of Wong's films. He created Jung's magnificent dresses for In the Mood for Love and was nominated for the Best Costume Design Oscar in 2014 for The Grand Master. He knows that a beautifully made Cheung Sam has the power to communicate as much as the dialogue can.
根据《城下指南》第201条， 124-125这个地区 是一个特殊寒冷地区， 除了车上面的御寒设施之外， 乘客必须要找到另一个人和他拥抱。
Wong is endlessly fascinated by the complexities of love, and his films delve into the repressed desires we keep tucked deep inside of ourselves. Many of his characters become unmoored, wanting what they can't have or mourning a lost love, unable to move on. In the Mood for Love is considered Wong's romantic masterpiece, his most emotionally devastating and visually stunning ode to forbidden love. Maggie Cheung and Tony Leung are utterly captivating as two neighbours who end up falling for each other after discovering their spouses are having an affair. It's a profoundly lyrical exploration of yearning and loss that is one of the most dizzyingly romantic films ever made. Wong's work is dedicated to the anguish of unrequited love and missed opportunities, which haunt his characters for years to come. While romance and passion is all-consuming, so is the bitter sting of regret that comes later, as they mull over what could have been. 2046 is a follow-up to In the Mood for Love, which focuses on the destruction that a broken heart can cause. Leung's character appears again, but he's now a ladies' man, flitting from fling to fling. Burned once, he is unwilling to risk his heart again. Like many of Wong's romances, it hinges on the tragedy of meeting the right person at the wrong time. Born in Shanghai in 1958, Wong moved with his family to Hong Kong when he was five, but he struggled to learn Cantonese and English. A sense of cultural displacement runs through his films. His characters are both emotionally and physically adrift, constantly in transition. Even though his films are not overtly political, Hong Kong's changing identity and underlying anxieties over the handover of power from Britain back to mainland China on July 1st, 1997 form the backdrop of his work. Happy Together, an emotionally bruising gay romance, was released just before this date. In it, Leslie Cheung and Tony Leung play a couple who travelled to Buenos Aires to start again. Isolated in a foreign country, exiled from their home country and each other as their relationship disintegrates, their story reflects the concerns that many Hong Kongers felt about the future of their city. Another notable date that Wong references is 2047, the year Hong Kong and China's One Country, Two Systems arrangement will expire. In 2046, his ravishing sci-fi love story, Wong looks ahead to the year before, imagining a futuristic place where people journey to recapture their lost memories. There, nothing ever changes, but can the same be said of Hong Kong as his 50-year deadline approaches? Wong has admitted in interviews that he felt alienated when he first moved to Hong Kong, and a sense of loneliness permeates his work. His films are visual poems to this feeling of urban alienation, his characters swallowed up by big city drudgery. The only way of escape is through their vibrant inner lives. Chungking Express is one of his funniest and most light-hearted films, but the quirky love story is essentially about people's struggle to connect. Sometimes the closest I get to any kind of intimacy is just brushing past someone in the street. The most meaningful dialogue they have isn't with each other, it's with themselves. Pensive voiceovers dominate the screen as people muse endlessly over Wong's favourite obsession, unrequited love. Fallen Angels, a dark comedy with hints of film noir, relies heavily on these interior monologues. In its glittering vision of nocturnal Hong Kong, it focuses on the loners, the drifters, and the outcasts. Everyone is desperately seeking the warmth of another human being, but they're confined to their loneliness, unsure how to reach out. There's an aching nostalgia to Wong's films, many of which are set in 1960s Hong Kong when he was a child. The director is lost in yearning too for a past which no longer exists. The sense of longing seeps into Days of Being Wild, his moody second feature. Leslie Jung plays Yudi, a restless Lothario, on the hunt for his biological mother while callously seducing women along the way. The film shares a preoccupation with time that is a running theme in Wong's work. There are frequent shots of watches, clocks, and calendars, while characters are constantly pondering the passage of time. When Yudi talks to Su Lei Jun, played by Maggie Jung, a worker at a snack bar, he remarks how they are sharing this 1 minute, and she will always remember him because of this.
This is a fact. You can't get back. Because it's already gone.
But despite these brief moments of meaning, time marches on relentlessly. Memories are the only thing that keep people bound to the past, and Wong's films are about the tyranny of never being able to forget. In Ashes of Time, warriors wander the desert, haunted by old love affairs. They're wounded, not from the elegant martial arts fights that they get caught up in, but by the pain of their lovers abandoning them. Their memories are burning embers that smoulder on, more radiant than ever years later. Love can never really be extinguished.
So.